Rap is an industry that comes with a certain lifestyle expectations that artists have to follow. So when you write songs about how much money you spend, you also have to show those things in real life. Because of this, many rappers have made dumb decisions when it came to spending their money that they ended up completely broke. At number 9, 50 Cent. At one point in his life, 50 Cent seemed to have an endless amount of cash. According to the Washington Post, his net worth was estimated to be at $500 million in 2010. When the rapper filed for bankruptcy in 2015, he was making $185K a month, out of which $72,000 went to his 18-bedroom house, almost everything else going to other expenses. But what completely ruined his finances was when he did a bunch of illegal stuff, including purchasing a sex tape of the mother of Rick Ross's child, the person he was feuding with, added a voiceover making fun of her, and put it on the internet without her consent. He had to pay $7 million in damages, and on a separate occasion, another court case required him to pay $17 million. All this reportedly exceeded his mere $25 million net worth, and 50 Cent went completely broke. At number 8, MC Hammer. It's understandable for MC Hammer to assume the good times will never end. However, that's not how life works. In 1990, Hammer's net worth was estimated to be around $33 million. However, only 6 years later, Hammer ended up filing for bankruptcy in the most famous celebrity financial disasters of all time. And fortunately for us, we have a detailed knowledge of where all that money went. The first thing that led to his decline was his $30 million mansion, and the fact that he had employed 200 people on his payroll, which according to Time, cost $500,000 every month. When filing for bankruptcy, he admitted to having several hundred creditors, including his brother, numerous lawyers, the IRS, a couple banks, limousine companies, American Express, department stores, and a football player, Deion Sanders, who he owed $500,000. Number 7. Lil' Kim. Lil' Kim wasn't lying when she said it was all about the Benjamins for her. Lil' Kim had trouble paying her mortgage after the bank first started foreclosure proceedings in 2010. After giving her a chance to sort things out, a judge ruled in 2015 that it was enough. According to the LA Times, the bank foreclosed on her New Jersey mansion a year later. Lil' Kim's many debts included being over $650,000 behind on her house, owing the IRS more than $1 million in back taxes, and being behind $186,000 on legal bills. In 2018, Lil' Kim was making about $18,000 a month, with $2,000 for her staff, $2,000 for wardrobe, and $10,000 for travel. These financial troubles came when Lil' Kim spent millions and millions on plastic surgery until there came a time when the court decided she was too broke to qualify for Chapter 13's specific type of bankruptcy. At number 6, DMX. DMX was a popular rapper in the late 1990s with 5 number 1 albums. But despite the fact that he had more cash than he knew what to do with, his financial situation was a complete disaster. He filed for bankruptcy in 2009, which was denied, and later in 2013 again, blaming his problems on poor financial management by prior representation. DMX earned as little as $1,677 a month and had between $1 million and $10 million in debt, which included owing $21,000 on a leased car at a whopping $1.24 million in child support. The judge threw out his bankruptcy filing, claiming that the inconsistencies in his financial situation made him untrustworthy. He filed another time in 2016 when he had no money in his bank account, no assets, and was desperately trying to save his house from foreclosure. In 2018, the IRS came for the $2.2 million that DMX owed them, and he ended up spending a year in jail for tax evasion. Number 5. Lisa Lopez. Lisa Lopez, the rapper of the group called TLC, had an extremely messy personal life. After dating football player Andre Rison, who she claimed had abused her, the charges were eventually dropped. However, one night she decided to throw a pair of the sneakers the two had a fight about in the bathtub and set it on fire. Apparently, Lopez was reportedly angry because he bought himself lots of new sneakers without getting her any. This led to the whole house being up in flames soon after. She got off with a $10,000 fine and probation. Rison even forgave her, and the two continued their relationship. However, the mansion was insured by Lloyd's of London, and they weren't as forgiving as Rison. According to The Guardian, the $1.3 million claim the company had filed against Lopez forced her into bankruptcy. This indirectly affected the rest of the group too, who then had to take $15,000 from Rison each in order to hire themselves bankruptcy lawyers, including Lisa Lopez. At number 4, Bow Wow, formerly known as Lil Bow Wow. The rapper had many hit records as well as many acting gigs throughout his career. For someone who has worked so much in the industry, you would expect them to have a decent amount of cash saved up over the years. However, based on what he told a judge in 2012, it couldn't be further from the truth. According to TMZ, Bow Wow told the court he made $4,000 a month, out of which he only had $1,500 in his bank account during a child custody case. 4 years ago, he had also leased a Ferrari F430 that he fell behind on payments for in mere months. The leasing company came for their money and gave Bow Wow a bill of over $200,000, which by 2012, due to interest added to the amount, turned into almost $300,000. By 2017, he struggled to afford the lifestyle he thought he needed to have, resorting to taking fake pictures of flying in private jets, when in reality, he would be flying commercial. At number 3, Young Buck. Young Buck learned not to mess with the IRS the hard way. After owing them hundreds of thousands of dollars in back taxes, agents raided his house and took almost everything of value, including his white leather dining chairs, his craps table, watches, tattoo kit, and refrigerator, which they later returned back. The rapper later claimed they took things they should not have, like equipment needed to do work and stuff that belonged to his kids, although the IRS denied those accusations. As it turned out, the tax issue wasn't completely Young Buck's fault, as there seemed to be some miscommunication between his lawyer and business manager about who was supposed to be paying them. There were also 22 creditors who submitted claims totaling $11.5 million. He allegedly tried to hide an appearance fee he received whilst in the middle of the bankruptcy case by having the money wired to an undisclosed bank account. This stupid step could have dismissed his filing, which later ended up going forward. At number 2, Nas. Nas has had a pretty long and successful career. However, after he married fellow artist Kelly's in 2005, things quickly went downhill. By 2009, she had already filed for divorce while being pregnant with their first child. That's when Nas's terrible financial situation became clear. According to Essence, while settling on the child support amount Nas would be contributing, the rapper claimed to owe his manager $700,000 and the IRS millions. However, the judge ruled that he would be legally required to pay $300,000 in back child support and alimony. Nas claimed paying that amount would bankrupt him. Kelly said claimed he made $150,000 a month, whereas his lawyer argued he made substantially less than that amount. In 2012, Nas lost his Georgia home after failure to make mortgage payments, and the mother of Nas's daughter took him to court in 2014, claiming he owed her more than $11,000 in child support. Turns out, Kellis was not the only ex not getting paid. And at number 1, T-Pain. T-Pain was the sound of hip-hop in the mid-2000s. Not only did he rap, but also sung styles of vocalizing like Drake and Post Malone on his long list of party anthems about partying and women. When the era of T-Pain's music ended, he made a whopping $40 million by the performer's estimation, as he told radio show The Breakfast Club in 2019. And then he lost all of it. Even though his financial situation is better now, he blames his losses on poor real estate investment decisions. According to the rapper, he let his manager handle his finances, who was way more optimistic than he was. His manager would buy complete dumps and think it should be fine by painting it. However, they never managed to sell off anything they bought. At one point, T-Pain claimed to be so broke he had to borrow money to buy his kids a meal at Burger King. And that's a wrap on rappers who went completely broke with dumb decisions. What do you think about the relevant question to the video? Let us know in the comments below. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. See you in the next one.